Hi, it's Katrina. From the oldest dog in the Americas to what happened to the people who built Stonehenge, here are 9 incredible archaeological discoveries. Number 9. The cracked Corinthian helmet. You probably wouldn't expect to find an ancient Greek helmet in Russia. However, surprise, surprise, one was recently discovered in a grave in the southwest of Russia that dates back to the 5th century BC. The helmet is in the Corinthian style, made completely of bronze, with widened slits for the eyes and a covering to protect the neck, just like the Spartan helmets you see on TV and in movies. Its interior is also padded to protect the skull and face of the warrior. The helmet would have been used by the Greek warrior hoplites, which were the famous foot soldiers in the Greek phalanxes. This particular helmet was found fractured and broken, yet still in pretty amazing shape. It is the only one of its kind ever found north of the Black Sea. Around the 5th century, the Greeks were establishing a kingdom in the area that would come to be known as the Kingdom of Bosporus. These types of helmets are one of the most well-known symbols of ancient Greece. The Corinthian helmet appeared in the 6th century BC and is often seen in artistic depictions being worn by the goddess Athena. Whenever a warrior died, it was the custom to bury him with his helmet by his side. According to the director of the expedition from the Institute of Archaeology of the Russian Academy of Sciences, this was one of the earliest models of this style of helmets. It was discovered while archaeologists were studying a necropolis of about 600 burial mounds on the Taman Peninsula. This place retained a strong sense of Greek identity, even though they often were in close contact with others such as the Scythians, which also greatly influenced them over the years. Even though this helmet was not found in perfect condition, it is still of great historical significance. Number 8. 1,000-year-old couple. An ancient tomb has recently been uncovered in China, revealing one of the oldest couples ever found buried together in a romantic embrace. This is the epitome of romantic archaeology. A husband and wife were found lying side by side in connecting graves, with heads each placed gently on a tile pillow and their bodies reaching out in a final gesture of love. This tomb dates back 1,000 years, and it was discovered at an ancient cemetery in the Hunan province in China. The bodies were also found with some pieces of pottery that date back to between 960 and 1127 AD. The grave was initially excavated by archaeologists in anticipation of a motorway that will open in the year 2022. It was a routine excavation before construction, but now the race is on to get as much out as possible before everything gets ruined. Yang Ningbo, the lead archaeologist at the site, told news sources that it is extremely rare to find a couple buried together in such a way. But what makes the discovery exceptionally rare is something called a fairy window, which is essentially just a window carved through the dividing wall of the two graves, designed to allow the couple to continue their romance once they make it to the afterlife. But who was this couple? There were only a few grave goods found with them, indicating they were normal civilians. But the fact that they were buried with anything at all in a very nice stone tomb indicates that they must have had some wealth, or that someone rich bought the tomb for them. And while these two graves were definitely the highlight of the excavation, there were still other graves discovered in the area. These graves were even older, with some of them dating back to 25 AD, during the Eastern Han Dynasty. Number 7. The oldest dog. Back in 1998, researchers excavating a cave on the western coast of Alaska looking for the remains of prehistoric bears unearthed a small chip of bone. This piece of bone was cataloged and put away until it was just recently inspected using modern DNA techniques. Scientists have now discovered that this old archaeological discovery is proof that humans migrated to North America about 16,000 years ago and brought their dogs along with them. This has really changed the game on the initial thought that humans first arrived in the Americas 12,000 years ago when the northern glaciers began to melt. Scientists now know that the ancient Siberians actually traveled through the Alaskan archipelago 4,000 years before that, making their way down the Pacific coast and bringing man's best friend along with them. According to the team leader on this study, Charlotte Lindquist, a biologist working with the University of Buffalo, they first thought the shard of bone was from a bear. It wasn't until much later that they realized it was actually from a dog. And now they know that the dog lived 10,200 years ago and is the oldest recorded dog in the Americas. Researchers are saying that the dog's genome has revealed that it was once related to the first known dogs on Earth, which were domesticated about 23,000 years ago in Siberia. And this discovery gets even cooler. Scientists did even more digging, and they discovered that based on the genetic differences between the Alaskan dog and its much older Siberian ancestors, the two dogs split from the same population 16,700 years ago and went down their own paths of evolution. Number 6. Ancient balls. An international team of curious archaeologists have discovered something a little strange in China. They found three leather balls inside a series of tombs near the city of Turfan in the Chinese northwest. These balls were found at the prehistoric Yanghai Cemetery, and they measure only about 3 inches in diameter, about the size of a tennis ball. Each one has a hard core of leather or hair. They are enclosed inside a leather casing, and they were once sealed with bands to remain tight. And while this might seem a little boring, the truth is that the balls have mystified and confused archaeologists ever since they were found. Nobody is quite sure what these weird balls were used for. They may have been utilized in ancient Chinese games of skill, like tennis, or they may have been used by ancient jugglers. I mean, nobody really knows, so your guess is as good as mine. It was probably some part of a mysterious lost game. The Turfan balls, as they are being called, date back to between 1189 and 911 BC, predating every other antique ball found. In fact, they are about 500 years older than the first archaeological evidence of humans playing games with balls in Eurasia. Dr. Patrick Wertmann from the University of Zurich says that ball games in ancient societies were some of the best ways of getting physical exercise as well as enforcing military training. Dr. Wertmann has suggested that these three mysterious round artifacts were used in some sort of game that involved horses, as the balls appeared in the region around the same time that horseback riding became popular. Maybe they were the first to play polo, or maybe they threw the ball to each other while riding horses? I mean, the possibilities are endless. Number 5. Ancient goose art. Normally, extinct animals are discovered because of fossils found by paleontologists. However, a researcher from the University of Queensland recently found an extinct species of goose after examining an Egyptian painting from 4,600 years ago. It all happened when the speckled goose in the painting caught Dr. Anthony Romilio's eye. He noticed that the beautiful bird was unlike modern geese that live near Egypt today. The geese depicted in the painting have bolder colors, more intricate patterns, and a generally more distinctive appearance. Here's why the discovery is so fascinating. The painting is known as the Maidum Geese, and it has been admired since its discovery in the 1800s. It has even been described as Egypt's Mona Lisa for its amazing artistic display. But throughout the last 200 years, nobody realized that there was an unknown species of goose depicted in the brushstrokes. The surrounding animals are painted in a very realistic way, so the question is, what animal was this? According to Dr. Romilio, there have been no bones from these geese found at any archaeological sites in Egypt. However, bones very similar to modern red-breasted geese, but not quite identical, have been found on the Greek island of Crete. The suggestion here is that Egypt may have been teeming with diverse animals 4,000 years ago. It's important to note that the ancient Egyptian culture came from a time when the Sahara Desert was more green and lush than it is today. There were elephants, giraffes, cattle, and apparently one particularly extinct goose. Number 4. Ancient Europeans mysteriously vanish. According to new archaeological findings published in the journal Nature Communications, and also based on skeletons that were unearthed in Europe dating back 7,500 years ago, the genetic lineage of Europe mysteriously transformed about 4,500 years ago. The new evidence is suggesting that the first European culture was suddenly replaced at this juncture, and nobody knows why. The co-author of the study, Alan Cooper, from the University of Adelaide, Australia, Center for Ancient DNA, said in a statement that something huge happened, and archaeologists are now trying to figure out what exactly it was. Scientists used mitochondrial DNA samples from 37 skeletal remains from both Germany and Italy. What they found was that the earliest farmers living in Germany were related to the Anatolian people from modern Turkey. This means that many people from Turkey replaced the hunter-gatherers of early Europe. But then, something replaced them between 5,000 and 4,000 years ago. Researchers are saying it may have had something to do with the Bell Beaker culture, starting at around 2,800 BC. they appeared in Holland and spread across Western and Central Europe. For example, in the UK, they completely replaced the Neolithic farmers responsible for building Stonehenge, who were from the Mediterranean and had more olive skin and dark hair and eyes. While there is no evidence that the Beaker people were violent and did it on purpose, they may have brought disease that wiped out the people who were already there. Based on the DNA evidence of early skeletons, there was a huge migration and genetic turnover in the population of Europe, likely caused by more advanced humans moving into the region and wiping out the primitive farmers and hunter-gatherers. Number 3. Viking warrior women. A grave in Sweden from the age of the Vikings has recently been discovered to hold the remains of a respected female warrior from the 10th century. This archaeological evidence has confirmed that women held prominent positions in the culture of the ancient Vikings. The amazing discovery was revealed by researchers working at Stockholm University after analyzing the DNA of the female skeleton, which revealed that she was about 30 years old when she died and no taller than 5 feet 6 inches. Hey, that's my height. She was found buried with a small hoard of weapons, including a battle axe, a spear, a pair of shields, a sword, and arrows designed for piercing armor. This woman was without a doubt a fearless Viking warrior, and scientists are saying she was not the only one. While many people already thought this was the case, there was very little evidence to support this. According to Professor Matthias Jacobson, this discovery was the first formal confirmation of a true Viking female warrior. Scientists have known for a long time that women played an important role in society, but this is the first well-preserved finding. And to make matters even more fascinating, the lady warrior was found with a pair of horses and an ancient board game complete with a full set of game pieces. This suggests that she was a high-ranking woman with deep knowledge of battle strategy and military combat. Number 2. Mysterious stone gates. Hundreds of fascinating stone gates have been found throughout the remote wastelands of Saudi Arabia, and it was all thanks to archaeologists using Google Earth. Roughly 400 stone structures previously undocumented have now been identified in the Arabian desert, and professional archaeologists are saying they were probably constructed by nomadic tribes many thousands of years ago. According to David Kennedy from the University of Western Australia, Saudi Arabia is not just a desert, but in fact a place with a huge archaeological treasure trove still needing to be identified and mapped. These particular stone gates are visible from the ground, but they become exceptionally clear from above, looking from a plane or at a satellite image. These structures are believed to be at least 2,000 years old, but Dr. Kennedy has said that some could date as far back as 9,000 years. Very little is known about whoever built the structures or what their purpose was in the ancient world, but scientists are saying that they could be the ancestors of the Bedouin people who still live in the region today. One of the best theories that archaeologists can come up with for the purpose of the stone gates is that they were built from loose boulders and used by nomadic tribes for hunting, by funneling stampeding herds of gazelles through a narrow corridor where they would be slaughtered by the warriors to be eaten by the rest of the tribe. The stone gates would have led to hunting on a massive scale and may have even led to the extinction of certain types of migrating animals. Number 1. Ancient Chinese trousers. The oldest pants in the world have recently been found in an ancient Chinese graveyard by a team of researchers. This happened at the Tarim Basin in western China, a place rich in ancient burial grounds that date back at least 3,000 years. At least that's how old these pants are. Out of all 500 individual gravesites explored in the region, only 2 of them were found to contain dead people still wearing pants. Carbon dating of the pants has revealed them to be the oldest known occurrence of human beings wearing the same type of trousers that we still do today. There were other artifacts found inside the tombs with the trouser-wearing skeletons as well. There was a horsewhip, a bow, and even a battle axe. Researchers are now suggesting that modern pants may have been created to allow people to ride horses for longer periods of time without chafing their skin. The invention of horseback riding incidentally provoked the invention of tailored pants designed to fit a particular person while being comfortable enough to ride around on a horse all day. Basically, you can thank the original horseback riders of ancient China for your comfortable jeans. Thanks for watching! What are your thoughts on these amazing discoveries? Let me know in the comments below and be sure to hit that subscribe button if you haven't already. See you soon!